Ah. Now here's what we know. Oh, nice. I remember borrowing this one off my mate Steve. I say my mate Steve, I mean his brother Paul, who was older than us and had a disposable income back in the days of the Sega Mega Drive. Oh yeah, we're going to start a game. I remember playing Boogerman. The pick and flick adventure, wasn't it? Something like that. Basically, a very good quality game. We don't need to know the story. Flatulent Swamps, I remember this music. Yeah, very good looking game, well made, good platforming fun. As far as I remember it not being as fun to play as, you know, it perhaps should have been. Gorgeous animation. What I also remember of it, wasn't there, yeah, there we go, was he's basically rotten in every way. What I also remember of it, was it was kind of cheap on the humour, you know, Boogerman, it's going to be cheap on the humour. He flicks snot at baddies, for goodness sake. I mean, truly disgusting. Just that, oh, look at it. It's like stringy snot, and no, just no. I was like, I don't know, 13, 14, I think, maybe when this came out. Maybe older, maybe 15. Great animation, great quality graphics, great solid gameplay. Just, I don't know, maybe I've already grown out of the cheap grossness of the humour. Booger. So that's a checkpoint, isn't it? It looks like a portable toilet. You know, everything in this game's got that kind of quality to it. That's really solid, though. I can't knock it. I mean, it's really solid. I didn't like it much back then. Let's jump down and see what's down there, what trouble we get into. Snappy, bitey things. I imagine they won't hurt me if I'm not falling. I imagine they will hurt me if I am falling. No, they don't. They're just background. Okay. No, you know what? Better than I remember it being this. Just nice. It's the solid gameplay that I like about it. It doesn't move too fast. It doesn't move too slow. It doesn't skid about. He's really nice to control. He shoots the things you aim at. I'm sure there's some excellent... Yeah, there we go. There's some really disgusting things to come yet. Remember some excellently animated special moves. Don't you go up the nose? Yeah. Just try not to be violently ill. You know, it makes me more nauseous now than back then. Maybe it's more effective now than it was back then. It actually makes me feel a little bit sick. Back then it was just like, oh, that's vaguely amusing. Lots of fart noises and snot flicking. It's stuff like... Oh, I see. It's stuff like... I'll see if I can do a special move. Does that just take me to the other loo? Oh, no, it doesn't. Cool, we got a bonus level. It's stuff like the special moves, which I particularly liked back then. Just the way they're animated. Little details as well, like the way he came out of that toilet. And there was like quite an overtly complex animation considering what he was doing, you know. I'm not sure even what they are. Little orange eggs on the floor. I'm going to try to see if I can do a C button move. I'm sure there's a good burp or fart move to be had on that C button. I think it... Ah, yes, swine. I think it varies depending on pickups and whatnot. Yeah, we've got a burp thing going on at the moment. Oh. Can't really aim it though. It's good though. It is a good game to play. A good platformer. I don't know. Was this a highly rated game in the day? You know what? I think its grossness actually worked against it. I think pretty much everyone found it infantile in its humour. But you know, because Sega games were kind of aimed at the teenage market, I guess. I mean, like the 90s teenage market. Early 90s teenage market, go a bit further to say, monster. And I think it was kind of a misfire, because I was part of that 90s teenage market, and, you know, a lot of the games seemed pretty childish, even like some Mortal Kombat with its gore, and I know a lot of people were into that. don't know, it just all seemed a bit childish to me as a 14-year-old. So maybe it was slightly misguided, but maybe it was just me. Ow, you horrible little beast. Ah, you horrible little beast. It's great, though. I do like the game. I'm just going to enjoy it for a bit. Yeah, of course you can jump on the heads. Of course you can. Oh, who needs to check if there's any goodies back there? We've got some kind of level boss encounter. No. End the level celebration. What is that? What is it? It looks like an egg. A fried egg in the wrong palate. Maybe it's like a rotten egg. Oh, I don't know. What is it? Answers on a postcard. I need to know what they are. Maybe I don't need to know what they are. Some kind of pile of dirt here. I'm not quite sure what that is. It is a filthy little game, this, isn't it? Ah, no, you evil little men. Get off of me. Yeah. I like it, though. I'd rather enjoy it. Cool. It's cool. I can't remember how far I got. I think I got past there. I, you know what? I think I recall it all looking a bit samey after a while. Oh, no. Ugh. Forgot about that. It is level 1.2, isn't it? So, you know, in the style of Green Hill Zone and so on. They're going for, like, multiple levels in the same style. Maybe I didn't get very far. Maybe I only ever saw the flatulent swamps. I don't know, though. I don't remember much variety in the backgrounds. As I say, it might be because I was rubbish at it. Let's, in this video, how long have we got? 6 minutes for? We're about six. The latter part of 6 minutes into this video. I don't think within 10 minutes we're going to make it to the next level. But we're going to have a flipping good go. Right. Up we go, Boogerman. Come on. That'll do, on the branch. Booger. He says Booger at some point. Oh, monster. Red. I like his voice. His voice acting's good. It's consistent as well throughout, and then he has that kind of, he has that same voice talk. I know that doesn't seem like a big deal, but 16-bit era games, the voice acting was often just, you know, so inconsistent. And I'm thinking more Amiga than Mega Drive. I think the quality level with that sort of thing wasn't really there. Until games like this a bit later on. Have that. Burp. Yes. Charged up a nice big juicy burp. You know what? I get more pleasure out of that now than I did then, I think. In hindsight, this is actually a lot more fun than I remember. Alright, we've done number two. Come on. Let's do number three. There's got to be only three flatulent, whatever the level's called, isn't it? Flatulent swamp levels. Maybe the three is a boss. Or maybe it's three levels and a boss, which would make it a cheeky four levels. But hey, we might still make it. Well, remember the little ghost thing, so we're definitely not in new territory yet. I've definitely seen all these baddies. We're just legging it as fast as we can to the other end of the level without any kind of ceremony. What's going on down there? Oh, it's not a hole. I thought it was a hole. Ah, well, come on, Mike. You have to do better than that if you want to get there before the time's up. I like it. I like Boogerman. You know what? I was kind of not dreading, but I wasn't really looking forward to playing this because, you know, my memories of it were, as I say, not particularly good. That dude was carrying one of the little green guys as a weapon. I like that. I like those slightly psychotic looking trees as well. yeah. It took my life in my hands a bit there. Leap of faith and all that. That's got to be the way to go, isn't it? Ooh, hello. That looks like some sort of bonus level. I'll tell you what, though. The backgrounds are different. Which is good to know. That wasn't good to know. That was just bad. Oh, not the beginning again. Oh, Boogerman. You're letting me down. Whoa. Whoa, how did I get through that? Oh, alright. My game plan has turned to nonsense now. I think we got continues and stuff. But you get the idea. Boogerman Sega Mega Drive. Actually, pretty good fun. Nice password system too. Thank you for watching.